Joining us now to talk about all this is Dr. Robert Murphy, professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
Hey, good morning.
Talk about Dr. Fauci's assessment. Are we still in a pandemic? And what do you think about the numbers of vaccinated people that have been dying of COVID?
Well, number one, we are still in the pandemic. The pandemic is not done with us, as he mentioned in the clip that you just had. And the sad thing is that, you know, people think that it's over and they're not taking the new vaccine, which is an improved version of the original. And that's going to play out in the next month or so as the expected increase in cases goes up.
And what about his thoughts saying that he is keeping an open mind about the source of COVID and a leak from a lab? What are your thoughts on that?
Larry, over the last year, there's been no new information. There's going to be no new information about this whole lab leak theory and where the thing came from. The data that you can gather and what independent international groups that went in there, they say it's most likely, 99% chance, that it's a natural phenomenon where the animals jumped into the humans at a market in Wuhan. Mm-hmm. That's about all they can say. You're never going to get any more information. The Chinese are so opaque. I mean, they've made such a mistake because, you know, they could prove it, but they'll never do that.
And what do you think about the lockdowns they're still having in China? Pretty severe restrictions. Is that the way to deal with it at this point?
No. When they put that policy in place, they really thought we could eradicate COVID. And, you know, they just aren't listening to the news. COVID is here to stay. It's worldwide. How are you going to live with it? What the Chinese are doing, mass testing, lockdowns like they're doing right now, and putting people in isolation facilities. This hasn't changed since the beginning of the pandemic. It paid off in terms of the number of deaths. The number of deaths in China is 15,956, according to the Johns Hopkins website this morning. The United States has 1.1 million deaths. So they've had very few deaths, relatively speaking. But the price they're paying now, it's just so disruptive to society. And they haven't vaccinated the people well enough. Talk about no boosters here. There's no boosters there either. So they're not ready to really sort of open the doors because their hospitals are going to get swamped, just like what happened.
Quickly, Dr. Murphy, is the next strain more serious, as some have suggested?
Well, we don't know what the next strain is going to bring, but I think you're referring to an article that came out. It was reported by Bloomberg from South Africa.
South Africa, yeah.
And they were taking virus that had been in an HIV-infected person, in other words, an immunocompromised person, and those people have the virus for a long time, and it mutates. And they found in a laboratory experiment now that the virus actually got more lethal. Now, it's a lab experiment, but it just tells you this thing is not over.
All right, Dr. Murphy, thanks for being with us again.
Good to see you again.
Thank you, doctor.
Good to see you, too. Take care. Check of the weather, Paul.
Yeah, good morning.